Paradigm Shift.
An educational comedy.
It's not a cause. Not a movement.
It's not a social group you can slap a label onto.
It's an idea. It's an intention.
It's an intuition.
A mindset in which reality can be explored.
A genuine expression.
Discernment.
Critical thinking and imagination.
To look inward upon ourselves.
To better understand the external world around us.
And yes,
few egos are bound to be bruised.
With our silly, strange, politically incorrect.
Your style of going about things.
Real and raw honesty.
Which invites you to be
to the fullest.
Hey guys, this is Katarina, and I am looking out my deck right now.
Overlooking Haleakala. This is just such a picturesque view, isn't it? My lime tree down here, and all the palm trees.
It's just absolutely gorgeous. I was looking from my kitchen view.
My kitchen counter. We go into my home.
Hi, Paul.
Hey, how's it going?
I was showing them the sunset. Go look at the sunset right now. It's amazing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, go look.
Oh, look at that.
Isn't that incredible? Look at Haleakala.
I know, we are so blessed. Look at that.
Look at all that verdant green and our lime tree. Just so fruit. It's fruiting right now. I need to go pick some.
I need
like a lime picker.
Yeah, we could reach literally off our balcony and pick limes.
Wow, that's so cool.
I love this life. Look at this beautiful home.
I know. This is incredible.
I'm so excited.
We're like living in our dreams, guys. Like, we're really excited about this because, not because, oh my gosh, and look, we walk in and it's 555.
Nice.
What a synchronicity. Like, that's our life.
That's totally our life.
This is our life. It's like, it's just everything feels so synchronistic. Okay, turn off all the lights. I want to show what it looks like from right here. Yeah. So I was showing this picture on Facebook earlier today of my little incense holder area and my two candles. And now I'm talking about how, like, there's this sunset, this absolutely beautiful purple pink sunset. When they talk about Maui sunsets, they're not kidding, guys. Oh, this light needs to come off too. Can you turn off that one?
Turn off that
one too. I want to be able to get the full color of it.
How about that?
That's a little too dark. Can you turn on that one though? Okay. Yeah. The sunset's starting to fade.
You're such a perfectionist.
I'm such an artist, but that's me though, Paul.
I know. So
I delight in perfecting things, like interior design, paintings, Paul's wardrobe, except for this.
I'm going to say, where am I about to go clean a house clothes?
Yeah, I like tucked in.
And I'm still tucked in. So let's do a tour of this beautiful home and talk about how, like, we receive what?
Look at the striations!
Oh my goodness.
Holy crap!
We're not talking about anything except
the
sunset.
Sorry, oh my god, that is the pinkest sunset I've ever seen.
Wow.
Wow.
You need a good camera to capture that.
I do. Look at that, you guys. That's as close of an approximation as I can get, but the areas on the screen where it looks yellow are actually like neon pink.
Like a flamed maple
like
in the sky.
Flame.
It's incredible.
That's really cool. Wow. What a gift.
What a gift. Wow, Maui sunset.
Gift. Check this out. Again, it's like neon. That's such an incredible
view.
Thanks, God.
Yeah, my heart is like bursting into like explosive millions of pieces.
I know, right?
ATV!
People ride ATVs on the street.
I
love Maui.
This is so cool.
That we had that in Costa Rica. I loved riding ATVs on the street in Costa Rica.
Yeah, but that wasn't such a jalopy though.
No, that was a nice ATV.
Yeah.
Maui ATV. So anyway, we're making this video because both of us are sitting here in our home feeling super grateful for it.
Yeah, because we were just previously living in a jungle house where there was, it was like a house that was sort of put together right, like...
Kind of. I mean, the code inspector was not there.
Yeah, so there was a lot of stuff that was broken and just falling apart and stuff, and it... Oh my gosh, we were so excited to move here.
We were.
So excited.
So yeah, so now we're here, we're getting our stuff moved, and the house isn't even put together yet. And remember, we had no furniture.
Yeah, because we sold it all in Austin.
We had no furniture 3 days ago. Mm-hmm. And now we're here. And like Katharina's got this perfect desk that somebody was trying to unload for like $120 or something. Look at this thing, it's so nice. This is exactly what she wanted. This is exactly the thing that she wanted. Yeah, I'm excited about it.
Yeah. I love it. And so I'm going to replace this with a white desk chair. And I'm going to put my easel right there and a long lamp stand with like lots of different lights and a piece of art over my desk. What Paul and I are doing is kind of interesting because I know that a lot of people do this thing where, you know, they can't have an art space because they think they need a living room. But Paul and I decided that we were going to like cancel that idea, live in our whole house. Because we did this in Austin, we used our living room as a bedroom.
It turned into this wonderful hotel suite. We went from boring one-bedroom apartment
and it was like this kick-ass hotel suite, right? And then you also had an office.
And then I had an office in the back.
Yeah, it was a cool use of space.
It was.
And so we like to be creative with our spaces, especially when they're smaller spaces, because I just think that it solves a lot of the different problems. What we're doing is... This area is going to be my little sitting area with like two chairs and a lamp and an end table. So it'll be like a conversation pit there.
Yeah.
And then that's a bathroom. I'll show you that later. Then over in Paul's space.
Oh, so
he hasn't set anything up yet. But
I know there's a perfect desk coming for me. There's going to be a really nice desk. It's going to go right here. I'm gonna have a low slung little bookshelf here for my business books and personal development books and the library that I have.
Mm-hmm.
And so just a little space over here to work with a nice comfortable chair. I'm looking for an Aeron chair.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna get an Aeron chair because I've always wanted one. I think they're really cool and they're really comfortable and ergonomic.
Mm-hmm.
So then over here, I'm also gonna have an area rug with a low slung coffee table.
Mm-hmm.
With like a piece of sculpture on it.
Nice.
Maybe like glass because I have two windows.
Yeah, that would be really cool.
I think
like
glass.
The glass pieces that you have at work.
Like the glass pieces we have at work. They're,
the gallery.
They're
awesome.
Really they're like $3,500 to like $6,000. And what they do in your living room is like so bodaciously awesome.
Yeah, it's like a freaking disco.
It's like
awesome.
A disco. These things are, like, you can't even appreciate them on video. I've tried to take video of them, but what they do with light, how they bend the light around.
Yeah, it's freaking amazing.
It's freaking amazing. I've never appreciated glass work until I started working in an art gallery.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, so I'm going to put one of those pieces like right here. I really like this one particular one. And I think it's the absolute best one. It's like the second cheapest. It's so awesome. It's like this $3,500 stack of five cubes.
Mm-hmm.
And just the way the light's going to come through, it's going to be so cool. I'm so excited. But more importantly, I'm excited about the fact that I can see it happening around me. Like I'm really visualizing it. And by seeing it in my eyes, in my mind's eye, I'm literally...
It's showing up. That's what happened with my desk, you know. I literally saw a desk just like this in my vision, and lo and behold, the space that I have to put it in.
Perfect.
Like it's perfect with the easel that I bought. Like remember how that easel just showed up and it was like 0.2 miles from the house.
Right.
It was like down the street.
Down the street.
Like this perfect easel. That was really when our house manifesting started.
Yeah.
Was when I started manifesting that easel.
Right.
And then like I started seeing it and I was like, yeah, I got really clear about what I wanted. I wanted one that had a drawer that had the ability to collapse. I wanted one that could hold my artwork of various sizes.
You wanted one that hadn't been painted all over, that was clean.
Yeah, I mean, this one has a bit of normal paint on the bottom, but it wasn't like somebody took a paintbrush
right,
and like painted
it. Like what you did to yours in Austin to like distress it.
Yeah.
So funny that you intentionally devalued your own thing in the past.
So weird.
Isn't it weird how people do that? Like, and us or ourselves included.
But the thing was, is I actually wanted to distress it.
I know.
Because I wanted it to fit in with the rest of our decor.
Which is also kind of distressed.
Well, it was vintage. It was vintage stuff, and that was the style that I was going for there.
Right.
But now, like, that I have this space, I'm making it more modern and contemporary, mm-hmm. because it matches the interior of the home, which is also modern and contemporary. There's a lot of, like, modern, retro-y kind of fixtures here, and there's recessed lighting, and white cabinets, and marble...
You wanted white
granite
cabinets.
Countertop.
You asked for white cabinets.
Holy shit, I'm living in my dream! Okay. I'm sorry, guys. I just had a moment. I have to, like, talk to the camera for a second.
Here, I'll hold.
Okay.
You talk.
I literally was having a dream when we were doing Denise Duffield Thomas's, what day was that? Or your ideal life, something like that.
Yeah, she,
remember
she had
we
a meditation.
Walking, we were walking around the room and all that, and but I feel like I've done it before as well.
Uh-huh.
And I was, like, standing in the corner of my granite countertop, looking at the refrigerator from this side, looking out at this space that was like this size of a room.
Sweet.
And I intentionally remember that I was sitting like with my back to it like this, looking out.
I, in my vision as well, I was leaning up against the granite countertop.
And I also had windows like this. Mm-hmm. I had windows like this and all of the fixtures were really modern. Everything was up to date. The bathroom was really nice. I had floors like this.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't see the rest of the house, like, beyond this. And so now I'm just seeing that, like, that dream came true. Because, like, I got the kitchen I want, you guys. So...
Yeah, granite countertops? Like, we established
worked,
that.
You worked
at a granite place.
A granite,
I can tell
place.
You right now that these are good quality granite countertops mm-hmm. made out of a semi-rare stone. Because I just know about them. Because I worked at a place, and I was very intentional about working at a place.
You were intentional about wanting a place that had a good dishwasher.
A good dishwasher. We have a really nice, this is not a $300 dishwasher. This is like an $800 dishwasher. It's a nice dishwasher.
Yeah,
it's solid mid-range.
And I have like these drawers that do this.
Oh yeah, we got the drawers with the auto-closing features, which is really cool.
I love these things. They're so cool. I don't touch it if I just like bump the door.
Yeah.
Oh, and also I want to show this.
Lazy
I
Susan.
Also wanted this. I also wanted a Lazy Susan type thing in my cabinets. And I've always really liked this area of a counter can get really gross and dirty. And
yeah, Lazy Susans make it
back.
So much better.
Yeah, it makes it so much easier. I love good design.
Mm-hmm.
I love things to be really efficient and to work well.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, I just also really love that I have... lots of shelving space, like,
yeah.
You know, I have a corner freaking
which is perfect
cabinet.
For your square plate.
It's great! It fits perfectly! And look at all of my cups that I got, like, two of them are dirty over there.
Yeah, look at all that, like, stemware that we got. We got those for, like, $6 for, like, the second
dollar. And we have cups!
We have great cups!
I love them!
Yeah. Hers says, hello, gorgeous. Mine says, blessed as a man of faith. Because I'm totally a man of faith. Like, I just totally, completely have faith that everything on the universe is working
for
my good.
As for you, man of God, pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, gentleness.
There you go.
1 Timothy 6:11.
Man, that's how I live my life.
That's awesome.
Faith is so key. Because, I mean, you gotta believe in something. A belief is really just a thought that we think.
Let me hold this for you.
Oh, thanks, love. I mean, a belief is really just a thought that we think over and over and over again. You can develop or generate
it's
a belief about everything.
It's only been 13 minutes.
Nice.
It's only been 13 minutes.
It's because we're gratitude bombing.
Whoa!
Yeah!
Time feels like it stands still when you gratitude bomb, guys. It's awesome.
It's awesome. You can live longer by just being constantly in a state of gratitude. It's fucking sweet.
Gratitude's awesome.
So anyways, so I feel like, a belief is simply something that you believe over and over and over again. It's simply a thought you think, and then you think it, and then you think it again. That's all a belief is. So if you want to completely change your beliefs around, all you have to do is think a new thought every now and then. And soon you're thinking a new thought, and thinking a new thought, and thinking a new thought. And then all of a sudden you've changed your belief completely. Well, I have a belief that anything that I want in the world is mine. I literally have that belief, and I just think it over and over. I'm like, oh, everything that I want on this planet belongs to me already. And I just simply haven't found it yet. And that's how we're making this place out of nothing. Like, we're asking for it, which means we develop a preference for it. We develop a preference for, you know, clean walls or nice trim. So how can you ask for something unless you know what it looks like? This is why we talk so much about visualization. Because visualization, seeing what you want in your mind's eye.
In your imagination. It's imagination, guys.
We're having an imagination party.
We are just like two kids over here,
right, just having
joyously
fun.
Creating our life with God. And it's really incredible. Because we just are able to understand that God is for us and not against us. We understand that we are favored, we are beloved, you know, we are part of God himself. And so of course we can have what we want. And of course people can have what they want. Of course you can manifest stuff into your life. Like, you're an empowered creator, and you're empowered through the strength of God and what he taught through Jesus. And all of the stuff that Jesus did was really incredible. Like, you know, turning water into wine and like walking on water of this stuff that you're able to do.
Raising the dead.
Like, you have that same spirit in you. You have that same connection because Jesus came. And so you're able to have this experience of experiencing the harmony and the love and the joy, the eternal love, harmony, and joy. And when something momentary comes up, like doubt or fear, you, by calling on Jesus and God, and
you have the ability. It's there. Yeah, it's so funny. Like, so I was raised Christian, but I never really understood Christianity. I never really got it, because I was like, so you got this sky dude. And the sky dude sent his sky son to here for some reason, because apparently he couldn't just fix shit with like poof or whatever. And I never really got it. And then, you know, one day I was on top of a mountain in Costa Rica, because that's not cliche, but that's where I was. And all of a sudden this like, I was like, all right, God, like, what the fuck, man? You know, are you real or what?
Yeah.
And at that time, like, just like instantly, my thoughts completely changed. And all of a sudden, I was seeing all around me. I was just seeing God, like, everywhere.
Hey, you were like impregnated with this new awareness.
I was impregnated with this new awareness, and I'm like, oh, that's what
you
Jesus
had a spiritual awakening.
Right, it was a spiritual awakening, and it's so cool, because for me, that spiritual awakening happened through Jesus. I was just like, all right, I'm so afraid to call on this name that I haven't called on in my entire life, like, with any sort of seriousness. What in the fuck is stopping me? Like, if I don't think it's real, then I would just do it because I don't think it's real. If I'm not doing it, it's because I'm scared. It's like, oh, I'll just overcome the fear. Hey, Jesus, are you real or what?
I had that same experience when I had my spiritual awakening, guys.
Yeah.
I want to talk about mine.
All right.
Because, like, I was in a really, really terrible relationship, and I had been, you know, like, heavily medicated for my fibromyalgia, and I was having all sorts of crazy things happening to me, and like, so much so happening in my body that I landed myself in the emergency room like 2 days in a row. And after that, I don't remember a week, like, because like, I was just freaking sleeping. And then I woke up, and my mom took me over to this retreat house, and the priest of the retreat house said, bring her here and let her rest, let her get away from everything that's going on. At the time, my brother was going to jail. My brother, like, was having all of these experiences of just total, it was really horrible, you know, like, it was just a really hard time in my family. And I don't know, something just happened inside of my body, and I just, like, was overtaken by just anxiety and all of this stuff. Oh, no, that's what it was. Tramadol. That was the painkiller that really sent me into this crazy, like, altered experience where it was like I was having hallucinations flash before my eyes of, like, you know, stuff that I was, it felt like I was in a different dimension. Mm-hmm. Like, what the fuck? Like, this isn't real. Like, I never done hard drugs before that, but tramadol, let me tell you, this shit they give you at the doctor's office. Whoa. So yeah, that experience was really wild. And I just wanted to talk about having that spiritual awakening experience, because what happened at the retreat house was I had a moment that night when I was there laying in my bed that I was just so frustrated because I wanted to die. Like, I was in so much pain and so much agony, and everything felt like pure chaos around me, and I had no clue what to do. And I was laying there, like, surrounded by all these images of Jesus, and I had this picture of Jesus in my room. I was kind of looking at it from across my bed. I was like, you know what? Show me. I said that. The next morning, guys, I shit you not, I look up, I wake up, I rub my eyes, I'm looking around, and I see, like, all of these sparkles in my room. I'm like, what the fuck? And I'm seeing them, like, from outside the window, and then there's, like, these purple, like orb, like aura things out there, and they're just there. I'm like, what is that? And like, there was something in my heart that was like, I'm showing you. You know, like, the conversations activated, because I didn't have that kind of like connection of being able to really play with God, with you know, what I really believe is Jesus, because, like, he was the picture that I was like, show me to, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this started that next day. I don't think I ever really explained that to you, Paul. And as I was walking out, I looked over at my mirror in my retreat house room, and I looked at myself, and I just saw, this red color around me. I was like, what is this? Like, and I'm looking around at it, like, because I can see it's like light. It's not like Crayola coloring, you know, it's diffuse. And so as I'm walking around, and I'm walking out the door of my retreat house room, and like I'm walking down the hall and just having this experience of like looking at people passing by and like seeing colors around them, I'm like, the fuck? Like, what did I take, right?
They got the good drugs here.
Yeah, but it's just like this experience of like, no, but like I'm following this voice that's telling me where to go. And so I'm walking around, you know, getting my breakfast and stuff, and my attention, my awareness is being taken to all of these different places, like as if it was like someone turning my head and being like, look, you know, and seeing the significance in what's happening. I saw these people that were gathered around this table, and they were there on a retreat, and this was during March, so this is during Easter, during, you know, Lent. And the people were gathered around the table, and there were a bunch of women, and they all had like green all around them. Like, it was like a group green that was there. It's like, why? What is that? And then every single time when someone would talk, like, there would be a flash of light that, like, before they spoke, it would flash up, and then they would speak. And I watched this pattern happen again and again. And I don't even know what that means, but it was just so cool. And this whole experience, like, it lasted after the time at the retreat house. It lasted for a good 6 months. And I went and got brain scans. I spent $4,000 to make sure that I didn't have brain damage, because I wanted to be sure. My mom spent it. I mean, I was a kid at the time, 18. And we got my eyes checked to make sure that I wasn't like freaking losing my mind, right? So all of this was really, really exciting for me, because it was starting to help me build my relationship with this thing that was awoken inside of me. Like, just it feels like I have this relationship with my intuition and my ability to follow the clues. You know, it's like life is like a scavenger hunt, and if you know where your intention is, like, the path lights up for the next steps to get there. You know, so that's how prayer works, and that's how this relationship with God works, and that's how, when, you know, Paul and I, when we pray to Jesus, we're like, you know, please show us what the next path step is. And, you know, that's the spiritual journey. That's why they call it a journey, because you're just following the steps. And so what we really want to show you here is that all of this stuff that we're showing you, we're not showing you because it's stuff. And we're not showing you because we're like, oh no, we're better than you. We want to show you this because I literally am creating this as I go and asking,
believing,
for, and believing, and then receiving.
It's very simple.
It is. It really can be that simple. I think the part that people get stuck up on the most is the believing part, because that's the part that society has programmed you to think, like, no, you cannot have that. Only these kind of people can have that. Only you have to be this old to have that. You have to do this before you can do that, before you can do that, to someday, maybe, prove your worth. Someday.
But tell us how you
but
really feel.
But tell us how you really feel. Someday, you will be worthy. That's what they say. And you see all these other people out there trying to chase their little sliver of worthiness in a piece of paper, in a document that says they're good enough. You know, I see it in so many different places. And I was that too. But I'm noticing that the more that I rely on this voice, this place inside of me that just is telling me exactly what it is that I need to know in any given moment, it's informing me of how I live my life, all of that other stuff has fallen away. And what's arising, because all of that fell away, I fell to ashes, you know, I have created and destroyed myself more times than I can count. And just, like, it fell off. And now we have this experience here where we are just being built in this way where we are able to really think and ask and believe and receive. Mm-hmm. But it happened through this faith journey of building faith,
yeah,
of having things go wrong and then having God, like and our connection and being empowered to use the information that comes to us and trusting it. Because I think that the thing that screws people up the most is that they hear the guidance but they don't trust it, because people have been trained out of listening to their intuition. They've been trained out of knowing what's right for them and letting other people walk all over it and letting people kind of get under their skin, into their head, and then it takes them away from their internal knowing, the part of them that knows what is right and how to get there. Am I blowing your mind? You look like your mind's blown.
Oh, I know exactly what you're saying, because I live it, just like you
yeah.
do. I mean, it's like, it's the whole ask, believe, receive. Well, everybody knows how to ask. Everybody knows how to ask, but the right way to ask is to ask specifically, let me show you the bed. We're going to take a walk.
We're going to take a walk and actually show that it's a Tempur-Pedic mattress and that it's actually a good one.
This is a Tempur-Pedic mattress. This is a queen-size Tempur-Pedic.
Let's demonstrate, babe.
We're going to demonstrate. This was not something that I had any idea how I was going to provide my wife, but I really wanted to badly.
Yeah, I did. I wanted it badly, too.
Yes.
Check this shit out, guys.
This is a genuine Tempur-Pedic bed.
Look at how nice this is. You have to hold it up and show them the naked chick with her ass.
Oh, naked chick. Here we go.
Yeah,
now it's officially a Money Power Sex video because
yeah.
we have, like, showed a picture of ass. Anyway, this...
Check out this gorgeous mattress. That came covered in a beautiful mattress cover.
It did.
That's, like, feels like a pleather, like, lush. Like, oh my God, this makes me just so happy to touch it.
Yeah, we asked for this, and we asked specifically, we said, you know what, God, so long as we're asking, we want a Tempur-Pedic.
Mm-hmm.
But remember, we said exactly that.
Yeah, we said we were not going to scrimp on this. And
no,
look, now I get to be the chick with her ass.
Oh,
I
yeah.
always wanted to do this, ever since I was like 8 years old.
Now
like,
you can
I
be that.
I want to sleep on a Tempur-Pedic. It was my lifelong dream, guys.
Time for a new...
This is the fruition of my lifelong dream.
Yay, lifelong dream upgrade. So anyway, we asked specifically.
I have to try to bounce off.
Oh, with the wine.
Dave, no, because Dave, Deva said that he wanted to see if I could bounce. Like, I told him that it's kind of hard because there's no springs.
Right, yeah.
Go get the wine glass.
Yeah, we're gonna do
I'm gonna talk to the camera, but you can go get the wine glass.
Here you go.
Okay, guys.
This is the most fun video ever.
I know, this is great. Okay, so I have to go get a hamper still. And we're going to do great with that. And Paul's clothes. We don't have tons of clothes, but the clothes that we do have,
I have tested them.
Really, they suit us. I like them. Okay, so back to the Tempur-Pedic.
Okay, so we're going to see how this works.
Oh my gosh, it really works!
Yeah.
This is really as much as I can bounce. It's really not easy to leave bounceable. You have to work for it, Dave said.
You do.
Work for it.
You gotta work for it. If you want to bounce on your Tempur-Pedic, you have to work for it. Whoops. That's hilarious.
What?
Anyway, so what we were saying was the first step is to ask. The second step is to believe. And remember I was talking about like how a belief is nothing more than a thought you think about over and over and over again?
Mm-hmm.
So step two, think about the thing that you just asked for over and over and over again. Especially think about it in gratitude by saying, thank you so much that I already have the thing that I'm thinking about over and over and over again.
Can you hold it? It's also getting to be 30 minutes. And we just crossed the 30-minute mark, guys. This is officially a television episode.
Yeah.
We can have our episodes that don't even have to be 10 minutes.
No, they can be whatever.
They can be whatever.
Because we just
we don't need to
invent life the way we want to.
Because we know that if you like what we're saying,
you'll just tune in.
And you're probably going to be a subscriber at this point.
Right, exactly.
Like what we say enough.
And then you just subscribe to the
and
thing.
And then you subscribe to the thing. By the way, subscribe to our thing.
Anyway, yeah. We need to take one frame of subscribe to our thing and just
and
sort
just,
of
like,
put it in the
video. Put it in there, kind of like, yeah.
But I'm too lazy.
Yeah, so you're going to hold this.
So anyways,
that's the whole point of that.
Yes. So anyway, the next step after asking is to believe. To believe is simply to think the same thought over and over and over again. Katharina and I said thank you for a house where the sun rises and sets through the windows. And we have exactly that.
We imagined it.
We imagined it. And this is how you believe. You imagine that you already
have
it.
Imagine it as if you're there.
Right. Like, how difficult would it be for me to imagine that I don't have a microwave oven when I can clearly see one right behind me? How it would be so hard for me to imagine that.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, if there's something that isn't in your current reality that you want to be there, you have to see it as if it's there.
Okay, back up. It's also about feeling it.
And feeling
like
it.
Like ease.
Right.
Remember, you need to have these feeling words that, like, mm-hmm. What is it you want to feel when you live in a place like this? You want to feel ease.
Yep.
You know, when I'm here eating this orange, you know, living in all of this beauty, I feel a sense of ease. And that was thank you, Shanti Zimmerman, and also Hawk Maisel,
mm-hmm.
for telling us about that word, because that opened my mind.
Yeah, that life could just
you know?
Be easy.
Right, and then also when I read Danielle Laporte's book, you know, The Desire Map,
mm-hmm.
all of the things we want to bring about in this world are there because you first want to feel something. Like, I wanted to have a house that everything worked and everything just was clean and orderly because it gives me a sense of ease.
Mm-hmm.
Because in the Carol Pelville energy typing system stuff, which I would really love to share more about, she talks about how I recognize that I'm a type 4 person. I prefer structure and order and to have things like in their place. And so as I started clarifying my desires, I realized that it's important for me to have a space that supports that energy of wanting things to be structured and orderly and in their place, because I love it. I love it. I feel so great in a space like this. It totally fulfills all of my needs for beauty and aesthetic and design and blah, 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 blah. Like, look at my Pinterest boards. They're filled with it. So, anyway.
Yeah.
So I'm eating my orange. You can continue talking.
I will. Here, hold the thingy. Yeah. Hell for you.
Yeah.
We're camera people for each other. It's great.
Yeah, it's fun.
So anyway, I was talking about the three-step plan, ask, believe, receive. I talked about ask. I talked about believe. Third is receive, and how on earth do you receive stuff?
except by going out and getting it.
Also, receive. That's where the ease comes in.
That's where the ease comes in.
Because you need to be in a receptive state.
Right.
After you've done the asking and after you've done the believing, you need to be receptive to it, otherwise it can't show up.
Right. You have to be receptive to it. So we were just really receptive to this house. I am really receptive to people wandering into the art gallery and just buying a Picasso. Super duper receptive to it.
This also is what ties into, I had to throw something in the garbage, guys. That's also what ties into money, power, sex.
Mm-hmm.
The sex part of this, because really, money, power, sex is all about manifestation.
Basically.
That's really what we're talking about here at Money, Power, Sex. We're talking about using spiritual laws that have been laid out by Jesus and other places that
all kinds
talk
of
about
places.
It. Like, all kinds of places
in
that
all
we
kinds
gather
of different
spiritual
words
wisdom.
Use.
Yeah, all of the different stuff. We have synthesized it through our own lenses and applied it in an experimental way.
You can like, flip the thing over to you. Here.
We have done this and used all of these things in an experimental way, and that's what we're living, and we're like living it and teaching it to you now, because we have synthesized this information in our own unique way, and we have our own take on manifestation because we've seen what works in our lives and how we're using it. So yeah, that's really what I was saying about what we're doing over here.
Yeah,
the sex stuff, the receptivity, that's all about being,
oh yeah,
being able to receive.
Mm-hmm.
And you
from
know,
both
you
a masculine
and, I,
and feminine
that
point.
Masculine feminine stuff is really important, and being able to me be in touch with my femininity, you be in touch with your masculinity, because I was already in touch with my masculinity and you were already in touch with your femininity.
Totally.
And that's how it is in this culture that we currently live in. But it's important for both of us, all of us, to be in touch with both, because it allows us to feel whole in ourselves.
Mm-hmm. So we're at like 35 minutes. I think it's time to cut it off.
Yes, and we also are going to go acquire more things tonight. We're gonna
beautiful
go,
things.
We are going to go get a comforter bedding set.
Yep, it's going to be awesome.
I'm so excited to show what that's going to look like, because it's going to feel like a palace.
Right.
Paul is the Sultan, and we make that joke that he's the Sultan. Because ever since I met him, this man, like, his last name is Roy, okay? Like, our last name is Roy. And that means king in French. So, you know, Paul has that, like,
that
embedded,
laid back on a cushion kind of.
Yeah, he has that embedded in his consciousness from many generations. So,
alrighty.
Let's go be kingly and have amazing beds.
Let's go do exactly that.
Talk to you guys later. Have a wonderful, wonderful evening. I hope that this video finds you well. And if you like it, click like on it, share it with your friends, and like our YouTube page and our Facebook page, and tell all your friends about us, because we want to meet them if they're cool. All right? And say goodbye, Katharina.